Now, before coming to division of fraction, let us understand a term which is called as reciprocal. Now, let us understand what reciprocal is. If we divide a fraction, or if we divide one with any fraction, we get the reciprocal of that fraction. For example, so if we divide one with any fraction, then we get the reciprocal of that fraction. So here, the reciprocal of 2 by 3 is 3 by 2. Similarly, the reciprocal of 7 by 2 is 2 by 7. The reciprocal of 5 by 9 is 9 by 5. So simply we get the reciprocal by dividing 1 with that fraction. Or we divide 1 with that fraction. Okay? So now let's come to division. Let's take up a fraction and let us understand how to divide. So we have 1 by 2 divided by 3 by 4. In this case, what we'll do is we'll write 1 by 2 here. Instead of division, we'll put a multiplication sign here. And we'll find out the reciprocal of 3 by 4. And we know that the reciprocal of 3 by 4 is 4 by 2, 4 by 3. So the reciprocal of 3 by 4 is 4 by 3. So here we have 1 by 2 into 4 by 3. Now always remember, now when we multiply, we have learned when we want to find out the product of fractions, it is equal to product of numerators by product of denominators. Here we can see that 2 and 4 can be cancelled. Always remember that when you want to cancel numbers, it is always numerator with denominator or denominator with numerator. But when you want to find out the product, it is always numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. So here, we can cancel this 2 and 4 here. 2 ones are 2. 2 twos are 4. So ultimately, now we'll multiply. Now, it cannot be cancelled further. So now what we'll do is, we'll take the numerator, 1 and 2 will multiply. And 1 and 3 will multiply, we'll get 3. So the ultimate answer is 2 by 3. So this is how we will divide fractions. Now let us understand, or let us come to the topic, simplification of fractions. Now, before coming to simplification of fractions, let us come to Bodmus. So Bodmus stands for bracket, of, O stands for of, D stands for division, M stands for multiplication, A stands for addition, and S stands for subtraction. In bracket, we have three types of brackets: square bracket, curly bracket, and circular bracket. We have another type of bracket, which is also called as bar bracket or vinculum. I repeat, this is bar bracket or vinculum, V-I-N-C-U-L-U-M. It is vinculum. So these are the rules we have to follow while doing simplification. We have to maintain this order. That means bracket has to be solved first, then comes off, then division, multiplication, addition, and subtraction. So let us take up a problem and we'll see how to solve a problem on simplification. We have here 9 1 by 3 we have here 9 1 by 3 into 2 1 by 7 divided by 2 5 by 6 plus 1 1 by 5. So first what we'll do is we'll change the fractions into improper fractions. 3 9s are 27 plus 1 gives you 28 by 3. 7 2s are 14 plus 1 will give you 15 by 7. Here we have 6 2s are 12 plus 5 gives you 17 by 6. 5 1s are 5 plus 1, 6 by 5. What we'll do is, in the next step, we'll solve the brackets separately. Here we have 3 1s are 3, 3 5s are 15, 28, and here we have 5. So we'll do it later. Let's come to this side. We have, now let us first multiply this. 28 with 5 gives you 140. And similarly here we have 7, 1 times, 7 will go 4 times. So 4 5s gives you 20. So what we have done is, we have basically cancelled 15 with 3, 3 1 times, 3 5s are 15. And we have cancelled 28 with 7, 7 1 times, 7 4s are 28. So we have 4 and 5 on the numerator and there is 1 on the denominator. So we'll multiply 4 with 5, that gives you 20, or 20 by 1, we can simply write it as 20. Here we'll take the LCM of 6 and 5. And the LCM of 6 and 5 will get as 30. You can work it out. 6 will go 5 times, 5 into 17 will give you 85. 5 will go 6 times, 6 into 6 will give you 36. Next what we'll do is, we'll add 85 and 36. So here we'll get 85 plus 36 will give you 121 by 30. In the next step, we have 20 divided by 121 by 30. So in the next step, what we'll do is, we'll take 20 into 30 by 121. Now, nothing can be cancelled here, because here we have 121 and here we have 20. So we'll multiply these two numbers. We'll get 600 by 121, and this number can be changed into mixed fraction. Now what we'll do is, we will divide 600 by 121 so we get 4 as the answer and 116 as the remainder. So what we'll write is, we can write it as 4 116 by 121. So what we'll do is, first we change it into improper fractions and then we'll solve the bracket separately and then we'll take out the bracket or remove the bracket and we'll solve further, and ultimately whatever answer we get, we'll change them into improper fraction. So this is how you'll solve problems on simplification.